Here's a shock most men go through when they get older. Semen volume declines, and there is no jet stream anymore. It dribbles. That hurts. Many men feel less manly when it happens. But not only that, many men fear hidden disease. In my daily work, I hear this often. Doctor, is there anything wrong with me? I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, one of the most copied urologists on YouTube. To understand what is happening here, we need to break down the physiology of ejaculation. I think it is possible to work around that problem to make it somewhat better. But I really doubt that the usual YouTube advice by non-urologists will get you there, because there's a fine line between what's possible in fairy tales and reality hitting you with a hammer. But speaking of, eventually it comes down to one principle. Fight the inevitable physical decline after 40. Since recently we have a buzzword for that, longevity, because it is as possible to accelerate aging as it is to slow it down. My mission on YouTube is to empower men to live 10 years longer. Longevity means slowing decline. That keeps you closer to the young guys. Let's start with the semen factory. I say semen so you understand. Technically, it's ejaculate. Semen refers to sperm, which is produced in the testicles. It may come as a surprise to you, but ejaculate is not made in the testicles. Ever heard the name seminal vesicles? They are glands behind the bladder, which are responsible for the majority of the ejaculate. The rest is produced by the prostate. Sperm from the testicles is only a tiny drop, so when you age, your seminal vesicles age as well. Do you remember my video where I talk about the 20-20-20-90 formula? Refractory period between erections, roughly 20 minutes when you are 20, 20 days when you are 90. The same principle applies to fluid production from your seminal vesicles. This means give it enough time. At 60, daily ejaculation will result in less semen volume. Abstinence is the number one factor driving volume. One MRI study with over 100 men directly measured seminal vesicle size at different abstinence intervals. They found a clear positive correlation. Longer abstinence meant larger, more filled seminal vesicles. The volume increases linearly with abstinence up to about 8 days, then plateaus. But here's the trade-off. While longer abstinence increases volume, it can decrease sperm motility and increase DNA fragmentation after about 7 days. This is why fertility clinics typically recommend 2 to 7 days of abstinence for optimal sperm quality. But we're not talking fertility here, we're talking volume. The older you get, the slower it will take for a refill. If you think this information is useful, subscribe, share, and like this video. Within the first 7 days, some of you also can activate the hype button. See it as digital applause. Online, subscribing is the clap. Thank you. Now, the burning question is this. Can you speed up production? Science can't answer this question right now. There are some reports from my patients that longer foreplay and high states of arousal over a longer period may have this effect. However, the Coolidge effect is scientifically safe. Here's how it goes. Men exposed to images of novel attractive women produced significantly more semen volume and motile sperm compared to repeated exposure to the same images. This isn't just psychology. It's evolutionary biology. Your body actually invests more resources when it perceives a higher probability of reproductive success. The novelty and intensity of stimulation trigger a neuroendocrine response that increases both the volume and force of ejaculation. That's actually part two of this video. Volume is part one, force is part two, because without force, volume can be diminished or may seem to be diminished. How's that? For the ejaculatory jet, a coordinated action between the muscles of the pelvic floor and certain parts of the nervous system are needed. Immediately before ejaculation, there's something that's called emission. The fluids of the prostate and seminal vesicles, together with testicular sperm, are deposited in the back of the urethra. You can compare it with loading the gun. Emission is followed by expulsion. This is done by the bulbospongiosus and ischiocavernosus muscles. If they don't work properly, expulsion is poor. I know what you're thinking. Strengthen them with Kegel exercises. This is exactly what you don't want to do. Here's why. Mostly these muscles don't work because they are tight and contracted, something we call overactive. What do you think happens if you make an overactive muscle work hard by training it intensely? It gets even more overactive. You worsen the problem. But why are these muscles overactive in the first place? Actually, that's not easy to say because many factors can contribute. The pelvic floor is connected to the rest of your body. Grinding your teeth at night, leading a stressful life, all of that can make your pelvic floor overactive. On top of that, your pelvic floor may be overactive because it is weak. Between the age of 30 to 40, bodily decline sets in. Among others, you start to lose muscle mass. This is called sarcopenia, and it really picks up the pace once you pass 50. It also affects the pelvic floor. When weak muscles can't cope with the demand, they become overactive. So in this case, you must loosen up the pelvic floor before you can even think Kegels. And here's the best advice I can give you. Work with a physiotherapist. Did you know that only a fraction of men know how to move these muscles at all? How can you train something by watching a video with exercises if you have no clue how to do them properly? It's simply not possible. Bottom line, getting older always means change. You can't stop time, but you can slow the decline. And that's where discipline and strategy come in. Semen volume is not random. It follows biology, abstinence, arousal, and muscle efficiency. If you want more, it won't happen by accident. It takes effort. My advice, fight sarcopenia, train smart, and work with professionals if you need help. Huge loads require a plan, not fairy tales. If you value truth more than sugarcoating, hit subscribe. That support tells me these conversations matter. In the real world, you'd clap your hands. Here online, subscribing is the applause. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched. See you in the next video.